Why does running suck so badly in the beginning? And more than that, why do we feel like we need to keep trying at it even though we don't like how it feels?
And thank you to Bose for sponsoring this video.
When we start running, everything seems to hurt. We can't get enough oxygen to breathe for 30 seconds of jogging at a time. Our knee starts to flare up. We feel like our body just isn't made to do this. And more than that, we're wondering, are we just not cut out to be a runner? When we were younger, running was used as punishment. I think we can all remember PE class being sent out for that mile run, ice cold, to run against your classmates. I remember thinking, am I just not cut out for running because all my classmates are beating me? And then we take that concept of punishment into our teenage years. We come into our bodies and we start to make choices about what makes the most sense for how we want to look. All of a sudden, I'm using running to undo unhealthy choices. I had pizza last night. Tomorrow, I need to burn a certain number of calories, whether that be on a cardio machine or with running. And here we find ourselves in our adult lives still trying to make running happen, still trying to love it. Why? Our friends who have hit their stride with it, they tell us all the time how beneficial it is to them. It clears their mind, it's gotten them healthy. What separates their success from ours?
Every time I stepped out of my door, no matter how ready for it I was focused on covering a certain distance or going a certain speed. As I start to get excited about running, I start following runners online, Instagram, Facebook, looking at their times, looking at their metrics. And of course, comparing myself to how they did. So now I'm pushing it, the distance, the time, focusing on what others are doing, and all of a sudden my knee starts to hurt. And not only does my knee hurt, I am also aware that I'm still running slower than everybody I'm reading about online. All of a sudden, I'm right back there in PE class in elementary school. So I give up, I quit, because I had determined that I am just simply not a runner. But let's not get to that point. What you need to do if you are feeling the way that I was is you need to take control of your running. First things first, control your route. It is not a bad thing to repeat the same route over and over. In fact, it does give you a sense of confidence as you start to find parts of your course that make you feel your strongest. I crushed that downhill today. I was faster on that downhill today than I was yesterday. And this is an important one. Just because you can run 2 miles or you have run 2 miles before doesn't mean that every run following that one has to be 2 or more miles. You should run less than what you can do, and you should make that a habit. We have to drop the notion of pushing it in the beginning of our running journey. Something that I was totally unaware of when I started, and I don't want you to miss out on, is the fact that elite runners and beginner runners actually share a lot of the same experience when they run, no matter where you are on the spectrum. Running gives us solo time, meditative experience. We get to be away from the chaos and stress of our lives. We get to get creative. There are a lot of benefits to running that have nothing to do with the speed at which you do it. Now, something that really helps me appreciate these other benefits of running and being outside is just taking a second to look around. We're in beautiful nature. When you're running outside, you're outside breathing that fresh air, getting that sunshine. Something that really helps me get out of my head and worries about how fast I'm going is putting something in my ear that's gonna be uplifting or motivational. I love these Bose Tempo Frames built-in headphones, but also let you hear what's going on around you for safety. I put these guys on, I throw on my favorite audio workout, which right now is one from the TRE mobile app. Down in the description, you can find that linked. If you guys wanna check out these glasses, also click down in the description, you can get a pair yourself. So how do you know if you're doing it right, if you're approaching this running thing the correct way? 2 things to think about there. Are you setting yourself up for success? Do you put yourself in situations that make you feel good or not good? I wanna recommend that if you are using running groups to stay motivated or show up, that you're not letting them get the best of you. Don't always compare yourself, use them as fuel, and don't worry about where you fall in that group run. And the second thing, stay focused on your running journey. Don't get too high or too low. Stay consistent and don't be obsessed with pushing it. Sometimes you should feel uncomfortable, but certainly not all the time, because even the most elite runners are not pushing it on every workout. And remember that everything you're seeing online from other people is their highlights, their best moments. What I realized for myself, my big turning moment, was that when I was in control, I felt best. When I actually went out with a plan and did a little bit less than what I knew I could do, I felt inspired to get up and go again the next day. It doesn't have to be extreme every time you do a workout. And when I finally had that click, I was able to get some real progress over days, weeks, and months. Now, my favorite way to take control of my runs is to incorporate walking from the beginning, using a strategy for that. Click right over here. I did a great video on why walking is so important and what it did to improve my running. On top of that, don't forget to go check out those Bose Tempo sunglasses. Headphones, they are awesome, and they are going to help you feel inspired to keep going day after day. Link down in the description. I will see you guys another day.